Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So this is part 2 video of sex determination. In my part 1 video, I have already discussed about the sex verification test. If you want, you can go check out that video. In this video, I'll be discussing about nuclear sexing, in which terms like bar body, Davidson body will be discussed. A number of times question has been asked from these terms, what is Davidson body and bar body. So let's study that now. First, let's discuss about the definition of nuclear sexing. It is a method of sexing cells which may help in determining sex in doubtful cases, decomposed, mutilated bodies and fragmentary remains. So as the term is suggesting, nuclear sexing. So nuclear means that it is related to nucleus of the cell, right? And sexing means determining the sex, whether the body that we have found is of a male or of a female, right? So with the help of nucleus, when we do that, that is known as nuclear sexing. Now for nuclear sexing, what we do is we do histological examination. Now what is histological examination? First of all, histology means it is the study of cells, right? Study of tissues using microscopic study. So we in nuclear sexing are going to examine the cells with the help of a microscope, right? So microscopic examination is done here, in which in that examination we are going to look for certain things like bar body and Davidson body. Now what is bar body? First let's understand that bar body is the condensed inactive single X chromosome that is found in the nuclei of somatic cells of most females and whose presence is the basis of sex determination tests that are performed. So bar body is nothing but an inactive X chromosome that is found in the nucleus area of somatic cells. We know that there are two types of cells, somatic cells and sex cells, right? So bar body is found in the nuclei or the nucleus of the somatic cells in females only. So bar body is a characteristic feature of females. It is nothing but an inactive X chromosome. The genotype of a normal female is XX, right? Out of which this is the main X and this is an inactive X chromosome. This is the one that we are talking about, is the bar body. This is a single inactive X chromosome. So this is a normal female, right? So in normal female, we can say that there is one bar body, right? One bar body. In Turner syndrome is an exceptional case. It is a sexual abnormality in which we have XO as the genotype of the person. In this case, we have one functional X and then there is O, right? So there is no extra X chromosome here, right? So in Turner syndrome, there will be no bar body. Whereas then there can be other sexual abnormalities also in which the person can have triple X as the genotype, right? So in this, one is the normal one and then we have two extra ones. So here we have two bar bodies, okay? It is seen during the mitosis in interphase nucleus. So bar bodies can be visualized in the interphase state of mitosis, that is the cell division cycle, and it is seen in the nucleus as already told, and it stains darkly. Small plano-convex mass of chromatin, it is seen as a small plano-convex mass of chromatin lying near the nuclear membrane. Here if you look at this picture, here you can see here is a bar body, here is a bar body, in this picture here is a bar body. So it is found attached to the nuclear membrane. Then the buccal smear is usually used, that is the sample is taken from the mouth. Now let's talk about Davidson body. It is also found in females and it is found in the leukocytes, or we can say WBCs, right? Leukocytes are white blood cells. Now, white blood cells are of 5 types, right? NEB, right? Neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil, and then we have monocytes and lymphocytes, right? So, Davidson body, this particular body is seen in the neutrophil leukocyte, neutrophil, right? Neutrophil leukocyte contains a small nuclear attachment that is of a drumstick form. Here is a picture showing us a Davidson body, and this is a picture of an XY person, that is, this is a male, and here we can clearly see that there are no bar bodies. In males we have only X, right? 1X, and the other chromosome is Y, so there is no additional X chromosome, right? So there is no bar body that is found in males. Then look at this picture. Here we have XX chromosome type. We can see that this is a bar body that is attached to the nuclear membrane. Then we have XY here. XY means we have only one X and the other chromosome is Y chromosome, and that means there is no additional X chromosome. That means there is no bar body. Here also there is O, that means there is no bar body. So you can see nothing attached over the surface. Here we have triple X, that is, one is the normal one and we have two additional X bodies. That means there's one bar body and there is two bar body in total. If the genotype is this, then this one is normal, and then we have three extra sets here, so they are going to be three bar bodies. I hope you understood the concept of bar bodies. In this picture you can see bar bodies mentioned here, and in this picture you can see drumstick like Davidson body. Then this is a table that is showing chromatin positivity in males and females, that is, first bar body. The percentage of bar body that can be present in males ranges from 0 to 4%. Why? Because exceptional cases are always there. In females, bar body is present in 20 to 80% cases. Then if we talk about Davidson body, then it is 0 in male, that is, Davidson body is never present in males, whereas there is 6% chance that Davidson body is present in females. Then comes fluorescent pheogen, 0 to 2% possibility in males and 50 to 70% possibility in females. What is fluorescent pheogen and what is quinacridone dihydrochloride will be discussed over here. These are certain reagents with which chemical reactions are done, and on the basis of that we can get certain positive and negative results. So if the reaction is done with fluorescent pheogen, then there are chances that 0 to 2% of the males are going to show a positive reaction, and 50 to 70% females will be showing. Similarly with quinacridone dihydrochloride, 45 to 80% males are going to show a positive test, whereas only 0 to 4% females are going to show a positive test. Now here's something to remember, that Murray Barr and Edward Bertrand, while studying on the stain section of nerve cells in cats, noticed a tiny dark staining blob that was always present in the nucleus of female cats and never in males. So Murray Barr and Edward Burton, they were studying nerve cells in cats, and they found out that there is a tiny blob area that is staining very dark colored, and it is always present in the nucleus of only and only female cats and never in the male cats. So it was subsequently determined to be an inactive X chromosome and later called to be as Barr body. So the people who discovered Barr body are Murray Barr and Edward Burton. Remember these names. They were studying nerve cells in cats. In decomposed bodies, sex chromatin cannot be made out because it is decomposed. Sex chromosomes XX or XY can be determined in the cells that are dividing. Example, the cells in which we can study those are bloodstain cells, cartilage, bone marrow, teeth pulp and hair root. Hair follicles are very important because they resist putrefaction, hence and both bar bodies and Y chromosome can be demonstrated. So in cases of dead bodies, hair follicle cells prove to be very beneficial since they are going to resist the putrefaction process, and in those cells we can find both bar bodies and Y chromosome, so they prove out to be very beneficial. Then quinacrine dihydrochloride is used for staining Y chromosomes, and that is seen as bright fluorescent body. Here if you look in this picture, you can see a bright fluorescent body over here, and this is nothing but Y chromosome that has been stained by quinacrine dihydrochloride. Then fluorescent fulgin reaction using acriflavin Schiff's reagent is used for staining X chromosome, that is seen as bright yellow spot in nucleus. If you can see over here, these are bright yellow spots of the nucleus that has been stained by fluorescent fulgin. So I hope you understood what bar body is, what Davidson body is, who discovered bar body. If a question is asked like in a given genotype, how many bar bodies are there? So you can easily tell that, okay, two bar bodies are here. If question is given like this, then we can say, okay, four bar bodies. And the Davidson body is drum shaped, and the percentage or the possibility of these bodies to be present in male and female. Then quinacrine dihydrochloride gives what kind of fluorescence, fluorescent fulgin gives what kind of fluorescence. All these things have been discussed in this video. In my next video, I'm going to discuss about a very important topic called sex determination using skull. So do check out that video also. This was all about this video. Thank you for watching.